Welcome back to part two of using the sum and product of the zeros of a quadratic function in order to determine an equation of a quadratic function. In part one, we made the connection between having the roots or zeros of the quadratic function and how that also gives us the factors of the quadratic function. Then if we multiplied this out, we would have this form of a quadratic function. And if we factored these two middle terms, we could rewrite this as a times the quantity x squared minus the sum of the roots times x plus the product of the roots. So the sum of the roots helps us find the coefficient of the x term, but notice how we do have a minus sign here, and the product of the zeros helps us find the constant term. And we're always going to let a equal 1 unless we have fractional coefficients. So let's use this to determine an equation of a quadratic function that has imaginary and complex zeros. We want to find an equation of a quadratic function that has a complex zero of negative 3i. The first thing to notice here is they're only giving us one complex or one imaginary zero, but since complex zeros come in conjugate pairs, if negative 3i is a zero of the function, then so is positive 3i. So we know this quadratic function has zeros negative 3i and positive 3i. Now that we have our two zeros, we'll find the sum of the two zeros and the product of the two zeros. Well, the sum's going to be very straightforward because they're opposites. Negative 3i plus positive 3i is equal to 0. And now we'll find their product. R sub 1 times R sub 2 is going to be negative 3i times 3i, which is negative 9i squared. But remember, I squared equals negative 1. So we have negative 9 times negative 1, which is positive 9. Since our sum and product do not contain fractions, we can go ahead and let a equal 1. So we have f of x equals, well, if a is 1, we can drop the parentheses. We would just have x squared. This sum here was 0, so there's no x term. So we just have plus the product, so plus 9. This quadratic function has zeros of negative 3i and positive 3i. Now if we graph this function, since the zeros are imaginary or complex, the only thing we can verify is that it will not intersect the x-axis. Here it is. Notice how it does have a y-intercept of 9 and does not cross the x-axis. Let's take a look at a second example. We want to find an equation of a quadratic function that has a complex zero of 3 plus 2i. And again, notice how they're only giving us one zero, but since complex zeros come in conjugate pairs, if 3 plus 2i is a zero of the function, then so is 3 minus 2i. So just as before, we'll find the sum of the zeros, and then we'll find the product of the zeros. So r sub 1 plus r sub 2 is going to be equal to 3 plus 2i plus 3 minus 2i. To do this, we add the real parts and then the imaginary parts. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. And then the imaginary parts are opposites. We have 2i plus negative 2i, which would be 0. So the sum of the roots is 6. And now we'll find the product of the roots. And these are conjugates, so it makes the product a little bit easier to find. We have 9. Now the next two products should be opposites. Here we have negative 6i plus 6i, that's 0. And then we have positive 2i times negative 2i, that's going to be minus 4i squared. But remember, I squared is equal to negative 1. So we'd have 9 times negative 4 times negative 1 is plus 4. So the product of the roots is 13. Again, we don't have any fractions here, so we'll let a equal 1 and drop the parentheses. So we have f of x equals x squared. Now the sum is positive 6, so notice how we'll have minus 6x. And then the product is 13, so we have plus 13. This quadratic function has zeros 3 plus or minus 2i. Now there's not much we can verify graphically here because we do have complex zeros, which means the function will not intersect the x-axis, so I think we'll go ahead and stop here. I hope you found this helpful.